Hi, my name is Melissa Sitorus, and in this video I would like to give the explanation about bound morpheme. Before I start, let me give the definition of morpheme first. Morpheme is a minimal distinctive unit of grammar, or more specifically, I want to say morpheme is a subsegment of language that meets three basic criteria. First, it's part of word that has meaning. Second, it is cannot be divided into a smaller meaningful segment without changing its meaning. And the third, it is relatively the same stable meaning in different verbal environments. So let's begin into the bound morpheme. Bound morpheme is a word element that cannot stand alone as a word. Bound morpheme need to use free morpheme to construct a complete word. For the example, if I make a word weighted, it is consists of two morphemes, weight and ed. Weight is a free morpheme because it is independent, it is, has a meaning on its own, and it can stand alone. Ed is meaningless. It is dependent to another word of weight to make itself meaningful. So ed is a bound morpheme here. It is because it can stand alone as its own. Bound morpheme is divided into two types, which is inflectional morpheme and derivational morpheme. Derivational morpheme is often used to make word of different grammatical categories from the root or the base word. When derivational morphemes are added into the other morpheme, they change the grammatical class. For the example, if I make the word drive, when I added the er, it's become driver. When it is only drive, it is a verb. When it's become driver, it's become the noun. Next is inflectional morpheme. Inflectional morpheme is used to indicate aspects of grammatical function of word. The carry grammatical information, and it is don't change the meaning of the words. We use it, inflectional morpheme, I mean, we use the inflectional morpheme to indicate if the word is singular or plural, whether it is past tense or not, or whether it is comparative or progressive. For the example, if I make a word of skip, when I edit ed, skipped, it's become a past tense. When I make it skipping plus ing, it become a progressive. Same as book. When I say it books plus s, it means that it's plural. When other example, when I say Jane's book, so it means it is possessive. That's about inflectional morpheme and derivational morpheme. Bound morpheme are basically affixes. In affix, it can be divided into prefix, suffix, and infix. In this video, I will give the explanation of prefix and suffixes. Prefix is a letter or group of letters that are attached into the beginning of a word to form a new word. For the example, rewrite. When I say rewrite, it has come from write as the base word or the free morpheme. It is added re. the in the beginning, and it means the prefix because it is attached to the beginning of the root word of right, and it is form a new word. Other example, if I say misunderstanding, unable, disagree, immortal, these are called a prefix. And it is also the bound morpheme. So we can call it as a bound prefix. A suffix is a group of letters that added into the end of the word. For the example, if I make a word of useful, it consists of two morphemes. For the first is use, it is free morpheme, and the second is full. Full here is a suffix because it is added into the end of the root word of use. For other example, if I say like creation, singer, hopefully, happily, or carefully, I think that's it, the suffix. If I make a word of the example like this, unfaithful, this is consists of three morphemes, which is faith here as the base form, as a free morpheme, and un here because since it is added into the beginning of the root word of faith, it is called the prefix. And full here, since it is added into the end of the root word of faith, it is called a suffix. I think that's it about my explanation of bound morpheme, and I hope through I explain in this video, everyone who watch this video will be easy to understand. Thank you.